Today we will be starting the first lesson of our science. Okay, before starting the lesson, I would like to share with you one incident which actually it's not exactly an incident, something where I was being excited, where I was, you know, surprised to see also. Yesterday I had been to a housewarming function of my friends. So we had we met all our friends and we were, you know, we enjoyed, we had a gala time and all. But then when it came to the lunch time, I had to my surprise, there were, you know, children, 16 varieties of sweets. It was really, you know, not shocking, but you know, most of the sweets I don't even know how they tasted, but some of them I know, the most common one. But there are 16 varieties of sweets which, you know, most of us even don't even know their names. Okay, that means my friend is a Bengali actually, and Bengalis are known for sweets. That means they have like, you know, they prepare lots of sweets. They like sweet dishes. All their dishes are full of they're sweet, you know, to taste. They don't eat such spicy food also. That means, children, each community cooks or they have different tastes of food. So our topic today is our food. So the first lesson, our lesson today is our food. Now the activity for this lesson is that you must have visited any one function, whether a wedding, a housewarming, your friend's birthday, something. There you must have seen the lunch, the dinner, whatever it is, you know. Just make a list of the items obtained from, whether it is obtained from plants or animals or other things, and just write the ingredients of that particular food. Just at least minimum 5 to 8 food items you must have tasted, which is different from your daily routine. Now, first let's go back to our lesson. Since many years, you know, we know that man's basic necessity is of 3: food, clothing and shelter. So we are going to talk about food. Now, this food, if you go, different people have, as I already told you, different people have different choices. You know, if you see the food items of throughout the country, you see each state has its own food item. That means India has got 29 states and 29 states have 29 varieties of food. That means if you go to Rajasthan, they have, you know, rajma, and Rajasthani thali is completely different. If you go to Tamil Nadu, you will get lots of sambar idli there. You come to Hyderabad, it's known for its biryani. If you go to Kerala, oil food, you know, everything is cooked in coconut oil because lots of coconuts are being there. That means the food is being made according to the taste of the people. That means the people's choice is different. It also depends upon the climate, the geography they live in. Now we will move on to this different taste. Suppose, how do the taste differ? Does it differ from person to person? No, it differs people within the country, it differs from people within the state. Why alone? It differs people of the same family. Suppose you take your own family. In the morning, if your mother comes to you and asks you, what do you want to eat? You must be saying, I want to eat puri. Your brother or sister will say, I want to eat, you know, chole. Your father will say, I want to eat idli, dosa, upma, whatever it is. So, within a family, you have people having different tastes. Different. That means the item is same. It is a food item, but you wanted it to be cooked in different varieties. Yes, that means the food should be cooked differently. Everybody will eat the same food. For example, if everybody will have cereals, meat, pulses, everybody will eat the same type of food, the same variety of food, but the intake is in different way. That means the food should be cooked in different manner. That means, children, right from breakfast to dinner, if you see, right from breakfast, the food in which you eat in breakfast, usually some of you like to have in the breakfast because the light food, you have to go for day, idli, dosa, you know, sandwich, some like to eat a fruit, some like to eat a banana, but never, children, eat a fruit on an empty stomach. They have something and then eat a fruit. Like that, some of them, if you come to lunch, some like to have rice, some like to have chapatis and all. When you come to dinner, some would just, you know, have a curd rice and a fruit. Some would like to have full-fledged meal. You know, it differs. So these food differs. The food items also different. That means food items, when they are made, it happens to see, if you carefully observe, the ingredients of each food item is different. That means the item, the food is the same, but the ingredients used in it are different. Thereby, it gives a different taste to the food item. Now let us see how it happened. Now, if you see, one amazing fact about here is that different food products are being made from one food only. Okay, that means you have different food products, but all belong to the concept called food. Now let's see here. You have cooked rice made of water and rice. You have veg fried rice. Okay, the ingredients are water, rice, peas, carrot, salt, oil. Chicken fried rice, you have water, rice, spices, oil, chicken, salt. Dosa, you have water, rice, urad dal. Chapati, you have water and wheat flour. Puri sabzi, you have water, wheat flour, vegetables, oil and salt. You have aloo ka paratha, which means water, which needs water, wheat flour, boil and mashed potato, salt, oil. These are the ingredients for to make these food product. Now what do you mean by an ingredient? Ingredient are the items which are used to make the food products. Now let's see, if you have carefully observed in this, you will find that in everything there is rice and wheat flour. The rice and wheat flour are common in all the food items. Either rice is there or wheat flour is. That means rice and wheat flour are known as staple foods. You know what I mean by staple food? These are compulsory in our diet.